Hello friends, welcome back to EduTab Himachal Pradesh Administrative Services channel. In this session, we are going to continue with the topic of government budgeting. In the last three sessions, we had spoken about the different types of budget, that is the capital budget, the revenue budget, and we understood the basic philosophy behind budget, what exactly is budget. So in this session, we are going to continue with the topic that is government budgeting and understand the different types of deficits that are talked about when we speak up, when we try to understand the budget. So let's move ahead now. So first of all, why we are trying to study this entire chapter? First of all, the relevance is, हम ये टॉपिक क्यों पढ़ रहे हैं? क्योंकि इस टॉपिक से प्रीवियस ईयर HPS प्रीलिम्स में क्वेश्चंस अक्सर आते हैं, तो इवन इन फ्यूचर दे आर एक्सपेक्टेड. हेंस वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस टॉपिक इन एंटायरिटी. अगर हम इस टॉपिक को अच्छे से समझ जाएंगे तो देन वी विल बी एबल टू आंसर ऑल द क्वेश्चंस दैट विल अपीयर इन द एग्जामिनेशन. सो द क्वेश्चन दैट वाज आस्क्ड इन द ईयर 2019 HPS प्रीलिम्स इज गोल्डन रूल ऑफ फिस्कल पॉलिसी इन इंडिया. देखिए, ये काफी टेक्निकल क्वेश्चन है. यहाँ पे पूछ रहा है व्हाट इज द गोल्डन रूल ऑफ फिस्कल पॉलिसी इन इंडिया. इज इट बोरिंग ओनली फॉर करंट एक्सपेंडिचर? अगर आपको ये शब्द का मीनिंग पता नहीं है तो देन आप इस क्वेश्चन को आंसर नहीं कर सकते. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट, बोरिंग ओनली फॉर पब्लिक इन्वेस्टमेंट, ये अगेन एक की टर्म है जो हमने डिस्कस प्रीवियस सेशंस में डिस्कस किया है. उसके बाद वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट बोरिंग ओनली फॉर रीपेमेंट ऑफ डेट. अगेन ए टेक्निकल टर्म है, व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इज डेट एंड ऑल दैट. आफ्टर दैट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट बोरिंग फॉर बजट एक्सपेंडिचर. सी, आफ्टर गोइंग थ्रू दिस सेशन यू विल बी एबल टू आंसर दिस पर्टिकुलर क्वेश्चन. सो फ्रेंड्स, नाउ लेट्स प्रोसीडेड. वी हैव अंडरस्टूड इन द प्रीवियस सेशन द डिफरेंट कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ बजट. The first component is revenue budget and the capital budget. After that, we have revenue receipt and the revenue expenditure. We have understood in the second part of the budget session what exactly are revenue budget, that is what exactly comprises the revenue receipts and revenue expenditure. And if you look at the capital budget, it again comprises of two components. One is capital receipts and the capital expenditure. So having understood all these terms thoroughly, now we will be understanding the different types of deficits that are associated when we talk about the budget. First and foremost, fiscal deficit is the most important terminology when we talk about the budget. So what exactly is fiscal deficit? If someone asks you, you should be able to explain them in a very simple manner. We have understood in the previous sessions when we are talking about capital expenditure and the capital receipts that fiscal deficit is nothing but the borrowings of the central government. We have been talking about this from the session 1. Fiscal deficit is nothing but the borrowings of the central government, and let us try to understand it in quite brief terms. So if you look at the total expenditure, I would like to again quote an example of the family. If a family is spending more than what it is earning, then it is running into a deficit. So similarly, that is a deficit of a family. Similarly, if you talk about the government, if the government is spending more than what it earns, then it is known as fiscal deficit. The term fisc, the term fiscal is derived from the Greek word fisc, which means authority. So wherever you are talking about the fiscal, it is associated with the central government or the state governments, the entities which possess the authority. So that is the hence the word fiscal deficit. And this term has been in use since 1997 to 1998. So now let us talk more about it. So what does it mean? The situation of fiscal deficit indicates that the government is spending beyond its mean. It means simply that more than its income, it is spending on its expenditure. That is the implicit meaning of this fiscal deficit. And how do you see, if when you are talking about family, you can say that the family owes 10,000 to someone else. But when you are talking about the government, the fiscal deficit is expressed in the percentage form of GDP. So that is, fiscal deficit is usually quoted as 3.5% of GDP and all that. So this is how it is measured. Now what we have tried to understand here is, we have tried to understand what is fiscal deficit. Then we have understood how is it measured. These are the two important key terms that we have understood. And apart from that, India has been a country of not only regular but higher fiscal deficit. Whenever during the LPG reforms in 1991, India was having a very high fiscal deficit. That it was, its expenditure was running so high that it used to resort to borrowings of different types in order to meet its expenditure. To bring a financial discipline, that is to bring a discipline within the expenditure of the government, FRBM Act was legislated. So what does this act talk about? It stands for Fiscal Responsibility and Budget Management. See, the FRBM Bill or Act provides rules for fiscal responsibility of the central government. It was legislated in the year 2003 and has been effective from July 5, 2004. So what are its objective? Its objective is to reduce the fiscal deficit, to adopt prudent debt management, and to bring about the revenue surplus. See, in order to have a tight check the Parliament of India wanted to have a tight check and maintain, make sure that the government of India again doesn't slip into a crisis like LPG reforms. Hence, FRBM Act was legislated, which had clearly stated that the government has to control its fiscal deficit within a certain range. You can study about the FRBM Act in detail, that is not within the purview of this session. So, having understood fiscal deficit, now let us move on to the primary deficit. So let us talk about, this is again a very important deficit. Again, this has been in use since 1997 to 98. So what are we talking about in primary deficit? Let me write down the equation for you. Primary deficit is nothing but fiscal deficit minus the interest payments. This is the equation, and in exams they directly ask what does primary deficit refers to. So this is the equation, that is fiscal deficit minus interest payment. Now we'll be looking at in detail with regard to this equation. So primary deficit indicates the borrowing requirements of the government excluding the interest. That is how we saw that fiscal deficit minus interest, that gives us the equation of primary deficit. And apart from that, the primary deficit does not include the interest payment made. That is what we are talking about. And this is again the equation. So let me give you an example how exactly we will try to understand what is the significance. See, the government will resort to borrowing in each financial year. That is, financial year starts from April to March. 1st April to 31st March. So, in the upcoming year, the government will be resorting to this much borrowing. That is the fiscal deficit in the upcoming year. But the borrowings might have been made in the previous year also. And whenever you borrow, you have to return back the principal amount as well as the interest. That interest is excluded. That interest payment is excluded. So we are calculating the borrowings that can be utilized for the expenditure of the government by discarding the interest payment. That is the essence of the primary deficit. If you look at this, it is the difference between the current year fiscal deficit and the interest paid on the borrowings of the previous year. So what does it signify? We'll look at it in the next slide. See, normally when the government, I have just now explained to you, when the government resorts to borrowing, it has to return the principal amount as well as the interest on that particular loan. In simple terms, the government borrowing excluding the interest payment. What does this signify? This is a very important thing you must try to understand. See, it is measured to know the amount of borrowing that the government can utilize excluding the interest payment. Suppose now if you are borrowing for... take a family is borrowing in order to meet its expenditure. Suppose it has borrowed 5,000, and out of that 5,000, if it has already outstanding interest due of 3,000, then hardly it can use 2,000 for its own expenses. Similarly is the case here. If we primary deficit signifies that if you are borrowing to meet your interest payment, then hardly you can use to meet your expenditure. That is how this primary deficit is indicative. And normally you can see that lower the primary deficit, healthier it is for the economy. So that is what is meant by here, and it is also expressed as a percentage of GDP. See, now again I would like to mention it here, fiscal deficit minus interest payment. is equal to primary deficit. Interest, this is interest payment. If the primary deficit is zero, it means fiscal deficit is equal to interest payment. And that is a very terrible situation, because all the borrowings that you are making, you are just making them to meet your interest payments on the previous loan. So that is not a healthy state. So that you have to bring down, you have to bring down the primary deficit. That is the entire goal. See the difference, that is what is explained in this particular line. And now, having understood the fiscal deficit and primary deficit, let us move on to the next deficit, that is revenue deficit. So in the revenue budget, we have talked about there are two types of component. One is the revenue receipts and the other one is the revenue expenditure. And the difference between the revenue receipts and the revenue expenditure is revenue deficit. See, just to give an instance, if a family, taking again the example of a family, if a family is borrowing only to meet its daily needs like food and other expenses, then that is a terrible situation for the family. Similarly, if the government is also running into revenue deficit, then the government of the day will have many troubles to face. So, since revenue expenditures are of immediate need, immediate nature, that we have also discussed this in the previous session, that the, in revenue expenditure, we are meeting the subsidies, salaries and other components. So, if you are running into deficit, that is in, you are earning, your earnings are not even enough to meet your revenue expenditure, then that is a dangerous sign for the entire economy. So, we have to avoid this. Since these are for non-productive or consumptive nature, excess revenue deficit will add up to the fiscal deficit. Now, let us try to understand this. See, how does the government try to fulfill this gap or deficit? It will resort to borrowing. The borrowing has always, whenever you are resorting to borrowing, you have to invest in the capital assets like roads, bridges, dams. So if you are borrowing and investing on these particular assets, they will accrue benefits to the economy over a long run. But if you are borrowing in order to meet your daily expenses, then that is not a healthy sign for an economy. So that is what is expressed here. And all having, after understanding what is revenue deficit, we also need to understand how is it measured. It is expressed as a percentage of GDP. That is how it is measured. Now, let us move on to the last type of deficit, that is effective revenue deficit. So, what exactly is effective revenue deficit? So, this was introduced in the Union Budget for the first time of 2011-12. Now, just now we have understood what is revenue deficit. It is revenue receipts minus to revenue expenditure, that gives us the revenue deficit. Now, revenue expenditure includes all the grants which are given by the union government to the states and the union territories. For example, take a look at those grants which will lead to the creation of assets. Let me give you an example. That is, government has many centrally sponsored schemes. Government has many centrally sponsored schemes such as Accelerated Irrigation Benefit Program and Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana. So, as a centrally sponsored scheme, we understand that 60% of the fund is provided by the center and 40% of the fund is provided by the states. And in this scheme, particular this type of centrally sponsored scheme, the central government provides funds to the respective state governments for investing in those particular assets such as roads, infrastructure and other such possibilities. So even such expenditure is included within the revenue expenditure. But if you look at the nature of the expenditure here, these expenditure are going out to meet a creation of capital assets. These are for the creation of capital assets, not the consumptive or non-productive assets. Hence, they have to be deducted from this particular revenue expenditure. See, this is what is stated by the finance ministry, that such revenue expenditure contribute to the growth in the economy, because if you are constructing road, that will be lasting for many years and it will reap many benefits to the economy in multiple ways. So hence, they are treated as unproductive in nature. They should not be treated as unproductive, as they are capital intensive in nature. That is why we try to deduct those kind of expenditure, that is revenue deficit. Revenue deficit minus grants given to state. minus grants given to states will take us to the answer of effective revenue deficit. I hope this is this gives us a very crisp and precise meaning of the term effective revenue expenditure. Since these grants for creation of capital assets are for the longer term where the economy will be benefited, hence we deduct those and arrive at the effective revenue deficit. So effective revenue deficit, I just now have given you example that the government of India grants forwarded to the states and union government for the schemes such as Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana and Accelerated Irrigation Program and many such other schemes. That is just an example. And in the end, we also try to measure effective revenue deficit as a percentage of GDP itself. As a percentage of GDP. And the expenses, though are shown by the government of India in its revenue expenditure, they cannot be treated as completely unproductive because we have just now understood that they are capital intensive in nature, that is capital assets. These lead to the creation of capital assets which will be beneficial for the economy for many upcoming years. Friends, that's all we have in this particular session. I hope that gives you a very clear understanding of the different types of deficits that are associated with the term that is associated with budget. Now this is a homework question for you. What does the fiscal deficit implies? See, the main reason I tend to give you homework question at the end of the day is after understanding a particular term, if you have to check whether you are able to answer any question from that particular topic. If you are able to answer that particular question very rightly, then that is appreciated. The main intention is you answer. Even if you get it wrong, but you will learn it, what exactly is the right answer. So that learning will help you in the process of preparation of exam, and you can commit all the mistakes during the stage of preparation, not in the main examination. Hence, I strongly recommend you to type the answer for this particular question in the comment section below. That's all we have in this particular session, friends. For more such interesting videos, please subscribe to our channel. Thank you.